The South Dakota State women's basketball team had just one game last week when they played in the first game of a Jacks versus Mavericks doubleheader in Omaha. After an early lead by SDSU, the Mavericks responded and led by as many as 12. Aaron Johnston's squad responded and eventually got the lead late in the fourth quarter, but Marissa Preston converted this three-point buzzer beater to defeat the Jacks 83-82.
Yeah, the Omaha game was a tough loss. The way it ended is obviously the gut-wrenching part. They made a really good play. Got a rebound, obviously, after free throw. We didn't quite get matched up the way we need to. Left somebody just far too open, and they found her. And then she banked one in at the buzzer. To me, that's the difficult part for most people. But for me as a coach, I think you got to get past that. That's something you can improve on. Really, our defense throughout the game was not quite where it needs to be. We can't give up 83 points and expect to win many times. I was proud of the team. I think we got down 12 in the second half and did a great job of just staying with it, being resilient. Omaha, to their credit, hit 16 threes in that game. Typically, if you're on the road and a team hits 16 threes, you're probably going to get run out. So just the fact that we were in the game and made some plays to have a chance to win at the end, there's a lot of positives there. But just as a whole, I hope our team is ready this week to get back to defending and just being a little bit better with what we do on that end.
The Mavericks made 16 of 29 three-pointers, a team record, and got out in transition, which led to several converted field goals. AJ says the defense will look to improve in both areas moving forward.
I think a couple things hurt us in that game. Some transition plays where they just got open and we didn't get to them on the three-point line. And then how we guarded the ball. So many of their threes came on penetration, driving to the basket, and we're helping a little bit, but just late in recovering to people on the three-point line. So quite honestly, if we guard the ball better, we're not helping as much, we're not scrambling as much, and that really hurt us in that game. And we just didn't have the urgency. A team hit 16 threes, that's one thing, but our defense is designed not to give up 29 attempts, you know, regardless of how many they make. That's just too many threes. So that tells you that we were a little bit passive getting out of shooters, and that's something that we'll have to put a little time into. Both teams we played this week shoot the ball well from the three-point line, so we'll have to be better in that area.
This week will be rivalry week for the women's basketball team. On Thursday, the women will host North Dakota State, and on Saturday, South Dakota enters Frost Arena for the South Dakota Showdown Series presented by South Dakota Corn. The Bison enter this week on a 5-game losing streak, but the Jacks will need to be ready for NDSU's physicality on Thursday.
Yeah, a big game. NDSU is always an important one. Long history there, long rivalry with them and USD. And to have both of those games in the same week twice this year, it's kind of neat, I think. It just gives our team a chance to really focus on a history that's much bigger than just our team. We don't want to make this game any bigger than the game, but at the same point, I think it's neat for our players to recognize that in women's basketball, very few teams have a chance to play in these kind of games that are this meaningful and have this much with them. So we're going to make the most of it. NDSU brings a very good offensive team. They're physical. Holy cow, they rebound. They move you off the block inside. They do a great job on both ends. And we got fortunate in Fargo that we snuck out with a win. So I think our team should be motivated and ready to go.
Saturday is shaping up to be a huge game for SDSU. The Jacks and Coyotes currently sit on top of the Summit League standings at 7-2. Setting up for a first-place showdown.
I think USD's balance is definitely there. Arns had so many big games early, I think people kind of felt like they were one-dimensional, but really what makes them good is balance, and they have a lot of players that can shoot it, a lot of players that can score. They're physical inside, they're deep inside. They're awfully good, and so we'll have our hands full with how we need to defend them, and they do a great job defensively. Keep everybody in front, they make you take contested shots, and that's where our offense will have to be better too.
Following Saturday's game, there will be just 5 games left in conference play, so both teams will look to gain the advantage, especially with how the league race has tightened up over the last week, with Western Illinois and IUPUI moving up to within 1 game.
Yeah, we're almost to February here. You know, we're moving right along, and it's too early to start, you know, watching the standings too much. We have everything in front of us. The teams that are close to us in the standings will play, so we'll either move forward or we'll move back based on how those games go. But I'm pleased with where the team is at right now. Certainly, could we be a couple games better? Yeah, we lost close at USD, lost close at Omaha. We also have won a couple of close games that could have gone the other way. And so overall, I'm pleased with where we're at. We've given ourselves a chance to be talking about a title, and now it just comes down to whether or not we'll play well enough to get that done.
Saturday will also be Alumni Day for the SDSU women. Former Jackrabbit players will be back on campus for a social in Club 71 at 11:30, and gather for the game at 2 p.m.
Well, we're excited on Saturday. It's a USD game, but it's also our alumni game. So we'll have some great players, past players, come back to Brookings. We'll do a nice social with them over in the new football stadium, so you get a chance to check that out. Many of them don't live locally, so they haven't seen that yet and haven't had a chance to experience what that facility is all about. So it's always a great day to have our past players back, and we're looking forward to welcoming them quite a few on Saturday.